Very quickly, we will start section 7 subsection 2. This is section 7 subsection 2, schedule 3. Schedule 1 was having 4 clauses. Yes. Permanent transfer of business asset, agent to principal, principal to agent, related party transactions, and last was import of service from related person. Yes or no? Only 4. Schedule 2, just now we finished supply of goods and supply of services. So some activity we have classified them. Okay. Schedule 3 talks about neither supply of goods nor supply of service. Therefore, we call it negatively as it is not taxable. Since yesterday only, we have already started discussing these items. Okay. First item is services supplied by employee to employer during the course of employment. During employment. So that is not a service. Therefore, whole employment class of India are not paying any tax. Salary is not under GST. Why? Because it is covered under Schedule 3 of Section 7, Subsection 2. Therefore, it is not GST leviable. Okay. Second is C. Now C have 3 items here. Okay. Constitutional function. So function performed by member of parliament, member of parliament, member of legislative assembly for state, member of panchayat, member of municipalities, and member of other local authorities. So their functions. So these are MP, MLA, MLCs. Their functions are not taxable under GST. Secondly, duties performed by person in a constitutional capacity, like President of India, Prime Minister, hello? All right, CBI, CID, all these are constitutional bodies. Yes or no? So they are also not taxable. Okay, next. Chairperson or director in a body established by government. So there are so many bodies established, like this, I told you, know this CBI, CID, this your IRDA, hello, or your this CAG, CNAG, Comptroller and Auditor General of India, who does this government audits and all. So they may have chairperson and members. Okay, so this is appointed by government, so their services are also not taxable. Okay, this is first C. Okay, this first C have three items, 1, 2, 3 arrows. Okay, now second C is also there, services by court or tribunal. Yesterday only I told you, in India we don't want justice to become more costly. Okay, therefore when you put case in court, court will, I'm not talking about advocate fees here, I'm talking about court fees, court, Supreme Court, High Court, tribunals fees. Okay, so they will just take fees from you, 2000, 5000 case registration fees. They will not take GST on this. Why? Although they are providing you service, but they are not going to take GST on it. Why? Because it is covered under Schedule 3. Okay, so this is the point. Next, actionable claim. Now, so far as actionable claim, I wanted to revise definition of goods first of all. From Sale of Goods Act, as per general definition of goods, generally actionable claims are not goods. With a common sense, I'm telling you, actionable claims are not goods. Yes or no? Actionable claims doesn't, bills of exchange and all this doesn't form part of goods. Hello?
Yes.
They are not goods. Bills receivable, debtors, they are not goods. They are actionable claim. Okay? They are financial instrument. They are not goods. But here in GST, according to Section 2, Clause 52, goods have three definitions, three parts. Goods means goods includes and goods excludes. Goods means any kind of movable property. Goods includes first item itself, actionable claim, things attached and forming, that growing crops, grass, things attached and forming part of land, and it excludes money and security. So in GST law, forcefully they have made actionable claim as a goods, forcefully. What is the intention of government of India then? To tax actionable claim or to not tax actionable claim? Obviously to tax actionable claim, because it is ordinary, it is not a goods. Forcefully you are making it as a goods. Look at the game now. Forcefully they made actionable claim as a goods, and now they are thinking that unnecessary we brought it into taxation, so let us put it into Schedule 3. Are you getting this? So they included in the definition of goods to tax it, and then they are regretting it by, and therefore they put it into Schedule 3. Instead of this, they could have simply said actionable claims are not goods.
Yes.
Which is general definition of goods. Hello?
Yes.
But look at the purpose why government have done this. They brought all actionable claims in the definition of goods. They don't want to tax it. But they brought all actionable claim in the definition of goods. They don't want to tax actionable claim, therefore it is written in Schedule 3. So actionable claims are goods but not taxable. Actionable claims are goods but not taxable, except three actionable claim. And which three actionable claim? Betting, lottery, betting, gambling. So what is happening, you understand? All actionable claims are goods. All actionable claims are not taxable. Only three actionable claims are taxable. So technically only betting, gambling and lottery is taxable. Balance actionable claims are not taxable. When I say betting, lottery, gambling here, it's not about buyer I'm talking. It's about a seller, person who is running this business. So if you're running casino, where people are coming and betting on it, hello, you should be taking registration under GST and you should pay GST, because you are dealing in actionable claim which is taxable. Hello, you are a lottery seller, you are a lottery seller agent, lottery supplier, you must get registration under GST. But sir, I am dealing in actionable claim. Your actionable claim is excluded from schedule 3. Hello, so only three actionable claims are taxable in this world. Which
lottery,
three? Lottery, betting and gambling. Balance all actionable claims are not taxable because they are covered under schedule 3. Okay. Sale of land and building is not taxable. Here also it came. Sale of land and building is not taxable. Just now I told you, sale of land and building is taxable. But when is it taxable? Before CC it is taxable. So what I have written here, sale of land and building is not taxable, but if it is covered by para 5B. Of schedule 2, para
5B.
That means before completion of CC,
yes,
then it is taxable. So after CC it is not taxable. If you want, you can write here, it is after CC. It is after CC. Okay, so this is after CC. Next, as I told you earlier also, after death, from birth we are paying tax. At least government should allow us to die happily without paying any tax. So after your death, whatever rituals are going to happen, hello, in those rituals, government is not imposing any tax because it is covered under section 7.2, schedule 3, funeral, burial, crematorium, mortuary, including transportation of deceased. Including transportation of deceased is not taxable because it is covered under schedule 3. Am I clear with this much? Okay. So we are done with the definition of supply along with this all schedule. Let's take a lunch break. After lunch break, we will continue with our question answer series.